Planning for the JAN intake and wondering where to start your interview preparation and what are the steps that you need to follow? Well, today's video has got you covered. I have with me Dinesh Vadada, who recently got his F1 visa approved, and he is going for the JAN intake and he is here to spill the beans, so keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and I'm a travel and a visa coach. On this channel, you will find tons of useful videos on the F1 visa process. We have an entire playlist for the same, so make sure that you check them out. I also have a lot more videos coming up for those of you who are going for the JAN intake. So if you are appearing for the interview in the next 2 months, then make sure that you subscribe and you hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of these videos. So today's video, I have with me Dinesh Vadada. He recently gave his F1 visa interview from the Hyderabad embassy and got his visa approved, and he is going for the JAN intake for a master's program. Now, Dinesh's preparation strategy is one of the most well-planned and one of the most sorted strategies that I have come across. And he gave a lot of thought and, you know, he really structured the entire process really, really well. So I have him here today and he is going to share his preparation plan and what he did to make sure to get his visa approved and also to prepare for the master's program that he is going for. Before we start, let's look at Dinesh's profile. So education, he has completed his BTech in the field of electronics and communication. Work experience, a total of 2 years of experience as a risk analyst. Admit is from University of Texas, Dallas. And program is for management science and quantitative method. So before we get on the video with Dinesh, let me tell you that the registrations are open for the next F1 prep workshop. This is a workshop which is a great way to get your preparation started. It's a 90-minute intense session, and this is especially useful for those of you who already have a visa refusal or if you have deferred your admit from the fall 21 to spring 22. So the link for the workshop to register for it and all the details is in the description box below, so make sure to check it out. And now let's listen to what Dinesh has to say about how he prepared and cracked the visa interview.
Hi Dinesh.
Hi Shafi.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Okay. I'm good. Thank you so much for taking out the time. First of all, congratulations.
Yeah, thank you so much. It's my pleasure to be here. I really thank you for all the support that you have given, irrespective of the time you've been there for me and you've been answering all my questions.
I'm so happy we could help you.
I'm a 2019 graduate. I've did my bachelor's in electronics and communication engineering from Gidam University of Chicago. After that, I have two and a half years of work experience. This is in the field of analytics. Then I moved to Amazon. Decided to pursue my master's. So I've got admits from University of South Florida. I've got it from UTD, University of Texas at Dallas, and then I've also got it from University of Texas at Arlington. And also have a couple of admits from NU, MPS in analytics.
So you have basically three other admits, right?
Yeah, they're in my studio.
Okay. And you're going with UTD?
UTD.
All of these three.
Correct.
Okay. So yours was, I think, the most well-planned and sorted interview approach,
correct.
Approach that I've seen.
True.
So can you just tell everyone, like, when did you start? What was the thought process, you know, that you followed? And why did you start so much in advance?
So first things first, I've a couple of friends who have been admitted and who went to their masters in fall semesters. But the thing I've observed is due to this pandemic and the consulates being closed, I've seen a lot of people stressing out mentally on this part. So I just don't want to take that risk. I don't want to fall in the same chaos. So I wanted to prepare it, get this out as early as possible. Fortunately, in the month of July itself, I was able to get the slot for August initially. But consulting a lot of people and consulting you, I've understood that we aren't supposed to give interview within 120 days. So then I've checked the calendar when this 120 days slot fits in. September 13th was the date, and I've got the slot on 19th and 20th, and then I've booked the slot. And
so just 120 days before.
Then I've started preparing. I started preparing in the month of July itself. But the thing is, I really have this habit. When I speak, I'll speak for a lot of time. People might get annoyed. I'll be speaking a lot of time. I use a lot of jargons and some technical terms which weren't familiar with other people. So I have a lot of complaints from other people saying that your pace is very fast and you speak very fast. So I figured these were my negatives, and just don't want to take risk, because visa part is one of the important factors. Because you do all your hard work, you get your admit, you do your research, and then if you go to the visa interview and visa officer says no, then either you have to reapply or probably you have to shift. That is why
so you started well in advance,
understanding the different types of questions, you know. So I was very fortunate that I've got you in this case.
So you really focused on the practice part as well, right? Because regularly you were practicing.
In the first days, for every 2 weeks, I made sure that I have a mock interview with you. Because just to understand, as I got some certain insights from you, you told me that a question can be asked in multiple different ways. You need to make sure that you need to be prepared in all the different ways, so that there are no surprises in the interview. So I made sure that I get exposed to as many questions as I could and as many times as I could give this visa interviews, so that I'm well equipped for the big day. So in the initial stages, where I have 40 days of time, I used to give visa mocks for every 2 weeks, and then when I've been close, like a month, 30 days is there for my visa slot. For every week, I used to give a mock, so that every week is a learning, and I used to shorten my answers, and based on your inputs, I used to tailor my answers, and I used to repeat it until I'm perfect. So that has really helped me.
So basically, with every session, we saw how things were getting refined.
True,
we were moving
true.
Towards like a more perfect set of absolutely. Answer structuring.
Yeah, correct.
So coming to the actual visa interview, right? So which embassy did you go to, and what was that experience like?
I went to Hyderabad embassy. A lot of people told me that Hyderabad was one of the toughest slots. So yeah. That is also one of the reasons why I've practiced well enough. But for me, the interview experience was not quite that difficult. It was easy. And this is all because of the preparation that I have. I mean, I've seen people, getting rejects there too. But I was confident enough because, you have already prepared me with all the different types of answers. There were certain questions that were not expected, but it was the same thing actually. While you told me, some people might ask you what are your master's plans. Some people might ask you why do you want to leave the shop. Since I've got a new job at Amazon, which is 3 months ago, and it is also pretty much in the same business analytics domain. So she asked me why do you have to quit this job at this point of time, because Amazon is also a big organization to work with. So why do you have to quit this job at this point of time and move on? Rather, you could gain certain experience here and you can still aim for the same role. That is the only question that I felt that it has been out of the box, but it was expected. And I just gave the answer as we described. I just told her that I have taken up this role to understand how data-driven operation works in terms of internet-based or e-commerce-based company. Now that I've gained experience and I see the field is dynamic, I wanted to upgrade myself. So that was smooth. And the couple of other questions were about funding, and the other questions were more into my father's profession.
Okay. Anything about the university, your future plans?
No, not really. Haven't asked about the university and haven't asked about my future plans.
So mainly they focused on your profile, for doing the master's. So that was us.
It's more into profile base and the funding, okay. Correct.
Okay, great. Any last minute tips for people who are yet to appear? I think next 2 months we will see a lot more people giving their visa interview now for the Jan intake. So especially for people from your own university, right? So anything specific you would like to tell them apart from all this?
Yeah, it's always better to be prepared from the day one itself, rather than, a lot of people think that they can give spontaneous answers going there, but trust me, it doesn't really work. So it's always better to be prepared. And to be very frank, I already referred a couple of my friends to your preparation process too, and I highly recommend that. So at least one-on-one mock session for 45 minutes that we do in the first case would be really helpful.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. I've shortlisted a couple of courses. So I started working on the courses from here itself.
Prerequisite courses.
I mean, for the masters in business analytics, one should aware of how Python programming and R programming works. I mean, you don't need to have in-depth knowledge for this, but at the same time, without having any knowledge on these programming languages and going there would be very difficult task. So at least you need to learn how these things work. At least till conditional statements also, you need to have some fair understanding of how this programming language work. At the same time, you need to be good at mathematics. Probability is one of the important factors. Probability and statistics were often used in the field of analytics. So these are certain prerequisites. So I'm just brushing up all my skills so that I'll be ready when I go there and rather than it's a challenge. And one of the important thing that I've done is I've started to interact with the professors right after getting my admit. Much before my visa interview. Okay. Right after getting my admit, I have interacted with my program director. I've started asking him what are the different types of courses, what are the suggestible credit hours that one can take in the first semester. So what are the prerequisites and what are the major factors to consider while taking up the courses? These are certain things that I've interacted with. I use LinkedIn. LinkedIn is my primary resource. It's an important tool. So okay. I actively networked with different seniors there. I've started approaching them. I started asking them about the different types of opportunities that I could get and what are the different teaching assistantships and research assistantships were there. What are the different ways that I can approach for these types of roles? So I've just made myself that I'm equipped with all the skills before going there, rather than starting new from stage one. Yeah. At least I've built something over here. So these are something, certain things that I've done before going there.
Great. I think all this is super helpful. So all the best for the road ahead. So like I said, yours is a very, like, the most sorted, planned approach to both the visa and the program that I've seen. Yeah. So that's great.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. Bye. Take care.
Bye.
In case you want to contact Dinesh, speak to him and get more interview tips, feel free to reach out to him. His LinkedIn profile is mentioned in the description box below. And just like him, if you want to prepare for your F1 visa interview with me, I'm here, happy to help. You can start with a one-to-one consultation session. This session is a great way to structure your answers, get your funding plan in place, make sure that all the documents are ready, and of course, to clear all the doubts and questions that you might have. You can also take a mock interview with me. A mock interview is, again, a one-to-one done on a video call. And this is a great way to build confidence and to practice, get all the practice that is so essential before your visa interview. So you might have seen from Dinesh's experience that he got tons of practice, and all this was done via mock interviews. So the session recording for both of these things will be shared with you, so you can always go back, refer to them whenever you need. The link for this is in the description box below. Make sure to check it. And I also want to tell you about the F1 prep course. So this is a course which is another great way to prepare for your visa interview. There are 11 video modules, templates, and sample answers. And you can prepare using the course at your own time and pace. So in case you don't have the time to attend, the workshop or take the session, this is a great way to prepare for your interview. Now the link for this, as well as all the other free downloads that I have, is in the description box below, so make sure to check it out. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that Dinesh Varada's experience has helped you and given some direction and structure as to how you should proceed with your interview preparation. We have a lot more videos coming up for the F1 visa, especially if you're giving your interview in the next 2 months. So make sure that you stay subscribed and hit the bell icon. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave it in the comment section below. You can also DM me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is @chachi.mal. That's all for this video. Signing off for now. See you in the next one. Bye.